Good morning. I'm Donna Hester, pastor of Kern Memorial United Methodist Church in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. And I want to welcome you this morning as we gather to praise our risen Lord. Our service this morning is a little different. It is a service of scripture and music, and we gather seeking the guidance from word and song from our Lord. This week on Wednesday at 5:30, we will be at Elm Grove Park again for family and fellowship. This week you are asked to bring your own dinner, and dessert and drinks will be provided. Since you're bringing your own dinner, there will be no RSVPs needed, but if you need a contact person for this event, please contact Lyman Bowker. As we come together, let us come listening to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
The one who calls us to love has been loving us longer than we have drawn breath. Sink into the arms of love this day and trust the hand that holds you. Let us pray. Wrap us in the arms of your love, O God, as we gather in worship. Teach us to be patient and kind in our actions and humble of heart in all of our ways. Help us see and know ourselves as well as you see and know us, that our words may be true and our love may be pure. Build us into a community that bears all things, believes all things, and hopes all things, in the name of love, which never ends. Amen.
Consider all the worlds I am.
Our Old Testament lesson this morning comes from Psalm 100, and I'm reading from the Common English Bible. Shout triumphantly to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with celebration. Come before him with shouts of joy. Know that the Lord is God. He made us. We belong to him. We are his people, the sheep of his own pasture. Enter his gates with thanks. Enter his courtyards with praise. Thank him. Bless his name. Because the Lord is good, his loyal love lasts forever. His faithfulness lasts generation after generation. Thanks be to God for this word.
All your ways are good, all your ways are sure. I will trust in you alone, higher than my sight, high above my life. I will trust in you alone, in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you, yeah. I will follow you, yeah. Light into the world, light into my life. I will live for you alone. You're the one I seek, knowing I will find all I need in you alone, in you alone. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you, yeah. I will follow you, yeah. In you there's life everlasting. In you there's freedom for my soul. Joy, unending joy. And I will follow. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow. Where you go, I'll go. Where you say, I'll say. When you move, I'll move. I will follow you. Whom you love, I'll love. How you serve, I'll serve. If this life I lose, I will follow you. Yeah, I will follow.
Let us pray. God of all goodness, We live in times of stress and controversy, injustice and cruelty. At times we cry to you for rescue and remember that we have leaned on you since our birth. We pray for our leaders and nations around the world, your healing, and that they may seek justice and peace. We pray for your church in all its forms, that we may be the love you want. We pray for the victims of domestic violence and victims of war. Grant your healing and give your peace. We pray for those trapped by natural disaster. Embrace them with your calm and send them relief. We pray for those who are ill or suffering, that they may feel the comfort of your love. We pray for your creation, that the health of the earth may be restored. Lord, enable us to be humble and kind in all things. Remind us that whatever the issue, today we know only in part. And even now, faith, hope, and love abide. And the greatest of these is love. Help us to be like you, love, through Jesus, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory for all. Amen. Our gospel lesson this morning comes from the Gospel of John, chapter 3, verses 1 through 21. And I'm reading from the Common English Bible. There was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a Jewish leader. He came to Jesus at night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God. For no one could do these miracles, could do these miraculous signs that you do unless God is with him. Jesus answered, I assure you, unless someone is born anew, it's not possible to see God's kingdom. Nicodemus asked, How is it possible for an adult to be born? It's impossible to enter the mother's womb for a second time and be born, isn't it? Jesus answered, I assure you, unless someone is born of water and the Spirit, it's not possible to enter God's kingdom. Whatever is born of the flesh is flesh, and whatever is born of the Spirit is spirit. Don't be surprised that I said to you, you must be born anew. God's Spirit blows wherever it wishes. You hear its sound, but you don't know where it comes from or where it is going. It's the same with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus said, How are these things possible? Jesus answered, You are a teacher of Israel, and you don't know these things? I assure you that we speak about what we know and testify about what we have seen. But you don't receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you don't believe, How will you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has gone up to heaven except the one who came down from heaven, the Son of Man. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him will have eternal life. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him won't perish, but will have eternal life. God didn't send his Son into the world to judge the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him isn't judged. Whoever doesn't believe in him is already judged, because they don't believe in the name of God's only Son. This is the basis for judgment. The light came into the world, and people love darkness more than the light, for their actions are evil. All who do wicked things hate the light and don't come to the light for fear that their actions will be exposed to the light. Whoever does the truth comes to the life so that it can be seen that their actions were done in God. May God's understanding be added to this reading.
Drink of the water.
Our New Testament lesson this morning comes from the first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13, verses 1 through 13, and I will be reading from the Common English Bible. If I speak in the tongues of human beings and of angels, but I don't have love, I'm a clanging gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and I know all the mysteries and everything else, and if I have such complete faith that I can move mountains, but I don't have love, I'm nothing. If I give away everything that I have and hand over my own body to feel good about what I've done, but I don't have love, I receive no benefit whatsoever. Love is patient. Love is kind. It isn't jealous. It doesn't brag. It isn't arrogant. It isn't rude. It doesn't seek its own advantage. It isn't irritable. It doesn't keep a record of complaints. It isn't happy with injustice, but it is happy with the truth. Love puts up with all things, trusts in all things, hopes for all things, endures all things. Love never fails. As for prophecies, they will be brought to an end. As for tongues, they will stop. As for knowledge, it will be brought to an end. We know in a part and we prophesy in part. But when the perfect comes, what is partial will be brought to an end. When I was a child, I used to speak like a child, reason like a child, think like a child. But now that I have become a man, I've put an end to childish things. Now we see a reflection in a mirror. Then we will see face to face. Now I know partially, but then I will know completely, in the same way that I have been completely known. Now faith, hope, and love remain. These three things, and the greatest of these is love. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Salvation to impart. You ask me how I know.
Receive now this blessing. God sends us forth with words of love on our lips. Christ sends us forth with acts of love in our deeds. The Spirit sends us forth with the Spirit of love, sustaining our very lives. Go in the power of God's love and be ambassadors of Christ's love and peace. Amen.